This is Coffee and Cocktails with MC, a show committed to introducing you to the interesting personalities of our business community in and around Anne Arundel County. Now for today's chat, here's MC.
And that's why this is called Coffee and Cocktails with MC. And today I am here at Allegram and I am talking to the owner. This is Amanda. Are you the owner, part owner?
I'm the owner.
Okay. Oh, all right. So we're at your Odenton location.
Correct.
But you actually have another location.
Yes. Our main headquarters is in Timonium.
Okay.
About 40 miles.
Very good. And those are your two main storefronts.
Right, both have showrooms. The Timonium showroom is a little smaller than this one, but Timonium has more manufacturing capabilities than we have here.
Okay, so this has got maybe more product to see, but the production and everything is more...
Mostly done in Timonium and then transported down.
Okay, so somebody can live in Odenton or come here to order the stuff. It doesn't matter
Correct.
That they're not in Timonium.
Correct.
Okay, very good. Very cool. So... tell us a little bit of background. How long have you guys been open? How did it start?
Well, the company was started in 1985. My mother had graduated from college, from Towson University, or Towson State back then, with a degree in finance and was tired of being a soccer mom and driving my brothers around to the soccer field. So she wanted something to do. So they looked around and they found a little business called Odenton Trophies.
Okay.
And they purchased Odenton Trophies. And it was for my mom to do. My dad worked in industry, and the business was really designed to lose money because they needed a tax break. So it was a hobby, really.
Okay.
A few years later, or even later that year, my father was bought out by Monsanto and signed a 7-year non-compete. So he decided to go to work in the trophy business with my mom.
Cool.
And now it didn't need to lose money.
We hope it doesn't.
That's right. That's right. And my dad is a Harvard MBA and had a successful career as a mechanical, electrical, and chemical engineer. And came to work in the trophy business with my mom. That happened in the mid-80s. I graduated from college in 86 and had a degree in biology and went on to sell medical supplies.
Right.
And I enjoyed sales, so my father tried recruiting me into the family business, and I fought it for a little while, but in February of 88, I joined the company, which was 30 years ago, last month. So I just celebrated my 30th anniversary.
Well, congrats. And your parents remained happy working and owning a business together?
They did, although they divorced in 91.
Oh, okay, never mind, sorry, we can cut that out.
No, it's fine. And the business has transitioned to me. I'm second generation.
Okay.
My father is now retired and spends half his time in Florida playing golf and the other half in Western Pennsylvania. My mom's still here in Maryland, out in Hagerstown now. And they aren't involved in the day-to-day operations of the business at all, but it comes up at family gatherings.
Sure. And now it's not just you, but there's another generation.
Yes, we have a third generation who started, my daughter Amber, my oldest, and she's been with the company, I think, coming up on 2 years, maybe 2.5, and she's learning the business.
Did we have to drag her in kicking and screaming, or did she go overnight?
No, well, she did her own thing for a while. She's 27, so she's, didn't start with me till about 25,
right.
So she experienced employment elsewhere first, but
maybe it's not so bad.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it's very fortunate, not to just be able to have a family business, but to be, I can say young because I'm not anymore, to be younger and to have that be your business, and if you want it, to be your legacy and something that you can
learn and grow with.
Absolutely.
Right.
And women owned.
Correct.
Which is huge.
100%.
So that is awesome. But, well, so we know how you got into it. What has kept you in it? Do you have a passion for trophies and awards?
not so much trophies, but the creativity. So I find it rewarding to take a sketch a customer gives you on a napkin or just an idea in their head and to turn it into a tangible award. And you know, that's our strength, that's our niche, it's what we're able to do. We can take blank product and decorate it like just about anybody else can do, but to fabricate an award from a design perspective up is really cool and it's a lot of fun. And it gives gives me a chance to be really creative. And as soon as I see a logo or a graphic, I start thinking, oh, how can I turn that into an award?
You know, cool. Who would you say, who's your main customer? Are we talking local sports teams or, you know, businesses?
It's pretty vast variety. There's certainly trophies and local sports teams. That's probably less than 10%. In the Odenton area here, there's the government aspect and Maryland Procurement or NSA and all of the different organizations in Fort Meade. And then there's also the corporate side of it. So there's a lot of corporate clients recognizing either years of service or sales awards or even customer appreciation, employee appreciation.
It's a hard industry to compete in nowadays, I think, with so many online.
There's a lot of online opportunities out there for people, but what online doesn't give you is that creative aspect. As far as I know, it's not available yet where you could scan and upload your logo and they'd fabricate a custom award to match it. People generally have so many questions. Well, can I do this or can I do that? Can you include this? Will this fit? What font is it going
to
be? There's so many questions that go into the design that online doesn't answer them all. But there are people who have it down to a science. They know exactly what, for trophies, for instance, they know exactly what figure they want. They know they want a 3-inch column in blue and they know they want a 2x3 piece of marble. So they can go online. They want, you know, two lines of copy, nothing spectacular, you know, just run of the mill, standard 10-inch trophy. And yeah, you can easily go online and order that. But when someone wants something that is a little out of the ordinary, an etched piece of crystal, something that costs a little more than an inexpensive trophy, they tend to have a lot more questions and want to be more involved in the production of it. So
you said run of the mill, but the thing that is interesting and that is not so run of the mill, if somebody could come in here and have you create something for them or work with them, to you it's run of the mill because you do it. But to them, it's more personalized, and they were like, oh my God, I had this vision in my head, she made it come to life. And they're like, well, that's just kind of what we do. But to them, that can be a big deal.
Well, when I say run of the mill, I mean something that has been around and been done for generations.
Industry standard.
A figure and a base, you know, a batter on, you know, on a base. And where the custom comes in is something, something more unique. Like acrylic or etching a wine bottle, you know, things like that we have around here that are just different. Custom coins, they're not run of the mill, each one is different.
So talk to me about this wine bottle. What's custom about it? I full disclosure, I don't see very well, so that gives you the opportunity to showcase a little bit more, but
So this is a wine bottle. A customer would bring us the bottle. We don't sell wine. And we etched here a name and a date and happy anniversary. We could also etch on the back whatever you want etched on there. Generally, it would have a name of some sort.
Sure.
We also etch glassware, all sorts of different barware, whether it be wine glasses or whiskey glasses, rocks glasses, pilsners, all sorts of things, ice buckets, to make a personal presentation.
Okay, very cool. I was looking at your table, and while I can't distinguish between everything, I saw the wine bottle, and I was kind of curious. I didn't know if you just set up a little vignette to showcase
cocktails.
I'm totally down with that. But that's
here's a wine bottle with a neck that holds glasses. That's another way of presenting a gift, and again, it's etched with a personalized message.
So really, it isn't just trophies and awards. And I think way back in the day, I remember I got a name badge here.
We do name badges.
you can think to do something like the personalized wine glass and stuff with gifts too.
Yes.
So that's pretty cool. There's a lot of creativity. Somebody could come in here and say, look, this is the occasion. This is what I'm looking for.
Absolutely.
Because you've got the experience, you can say, well,
I'd recommend this, that, or the
other.
Yep.
Are they drinkers? No. Okay. Put away the wine bottle. All right. Very cool. So what is your walk-in traffic like then? Who's walking in here? Or do you have walk-in traffic?
We have walk-in traffic. A lot of times people in the military will come in and get ideas and then take it back to base and get permission or contract or whatever. Or team moms will come in to get ideas for, you know, what they want to give in terms of awards for the banquet. And then corporate customers come in. They come in to look around to see what's available. They don't
right.
necessarily know what they want. And some look online and will call.
Right. You can get an idea when you look online, but if you can't touch it. And,
right.
And
you want to feel how heavy it is.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I think that's cool. I see so many things, like I said, that I didn't even consider. Can someone bring something in to be?
Yes, we do. We have lots of different ways that we engrave. So generally speaking, we can find a way to mark anything.
Okay.
And we will engrave customers' merchandise. Now there's a catch. We have a waiver.
Yeah.
You know, unfortunately,
sure,
in this
day
and age. Right.
Yeah.
We can't be held responsible, and we don't know for sure what it's made of, so we don't know 100% how it's going to react. But we have a pretty high success rate. We wouldn't offer it if we failed a lot.
Sure.
And they can bring an item in, and we'll figure out a way to engrave it. We not only do traditional diamond drag engraving and routing, but we do laser engraving. We do a chemical etch with the laser, as well as sandblasting and direct UV printing, sublimation too, and vinyl graphics. So between all those processes, we can figure out a way to mark your item.
You lost me halfway through. I just kept nodding and smiling and pretending I had a clue. I recognized some words, but not everything. So I'm guessing if somebody wanted to understand the difference between those, they could probably find that out by going to your website.
It's all on the website.
Right.
Yes.
I mean, obviously coming into here, they could, you know, look around
and we show samples.
Explain mm-hmm. the difference between things. Yeah. What has been one of the, or give me a couple examples of some of the more fun or unique ideas that you've done over time, if that's not putting you on the spot.
There are so many. One project that sticks out was Under Armour, and it was actually our first job we did with Under Armour, and it was their 10-year anniversary of a tournament that they did up in New York. And so they wanted the X for the Roman numeral 10,
right?
But they wanted 10 of them. And on each of the 10 X's, they wanted them then to somehow hang together. And each of the 10 X's, the original inquiry came in wanting a graphic on each one.
Okay, so Under Armour, because you threw out the name, so I guess that's impressive. You know, that you've done work for them, and they're a regular client now?
Yeah, they could still be more regular, but no, they're... But now we enjoy their projects. They're
right.
They're always looking for something unique and creative, and it's a challenge, but it's fun.
Yeah, they're a very progressive company.
Yes.
So, and that's awesome. Though, you know, you think of a big name like Under Armour, which might not necessarily always think to look for a local business and stuff. Why do people choose you? How do they find you? Are they looking for a small, like, local business? Is it word of mouth? What do you think it is that has gotten you the business?
I think a lot of it is repeat business. Once someone does business with someone and likes what mm-hmm. you know, the service they had and the product they had, they tend to come back. We try to ask all of our customers when they're new and they come in, how did you find us?
Right.
And these days, all we hear is Google, 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 Google. Now, we don't ask what did you Google or
sure.
you know, but. I think customers are looking to do something, and they're putting that in Google, and we're coming up as a reputable place to have it done.
And there are so many people now who really are embracing and do believe in shop local and support local business, that and that's awesome, because you know, you do, you can Google and you can find awards websites. I mean, I've seen it, I've, you know, so the fact that people say, okay, well, yeah, no, that's not what I want, you know, or I'd rather have that personalized, you know, attention, that speaks volumes, because I think there's a generation now where...
Oh, yeah. Well, there's a generation now where they don't want to go into a store. They
right.
want to have everything answered online, and we struggle to be able to offer that. Our website is a shopping cart-enabled site. You can add things to a cart and check out just for that generation that doesn't
right.
want to come in.
Right. Yeah. I mean, we're an Amazon generation actually getting to this point. So you found it a challenge, hard? I mean, does that just motivate you more to continue to...
It's a challenge for sure. I always look for ways to embrace technology and have technology make doing business easier.
Right.
A better customer experience, easier for us, quicker manufacturing, better accuracy, efficiency, all that. I belong to a group called the Award Associates of America, mm-hmm. and it's basically 65 of the top retailers in the country and Canada. And we meet twice a year at least, and we pool our resources, and it has given me a huge advantage to learn and to share and to figure out what is the best way to do something. I don't have to reinvent the wheel.
Right.
Someone's already done it. So that's helped us tremendously to grow and be able to offer our customers cutting edge product.
Sure.
And I have a commitment every year. I try to buy a new piece of equipment that'll give us a new technology that, you know, will allow us to do something we couldn't do before. So that is something, you know, I learned, take advantage of that Section 179
right.
tax deduction and try to grow. And I don't think many retailers in our industry believe that. And they're happy stagnant. They're happy where they are.
It's
and
maintaining the status
maintaining.
Quo.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what is your latest and greatest piece of equipment that's awesome, and I'm not going to understand anything about it, but that, you know, you have that you're excited about, or technology or something that you can offer now that in recent years you haven't? Like, what's one
so
of the newer
the
technologies?
The most recent piece of equipment we bought is a Mylar printer. So it allows us to print Mylars to apply to awards.
Okay.
So before that, we had to buy them. But that's kind of a boring piece of equipment. The most exciting piece of equipment, most recent exciting piece of equipment is a direct UV printer.
Okay.
So whatever we put in the printer, it prints in full color on it. So
okay.
it can be anything from a coffee mug to,
nice.
You know, whatever you put in there that'll fit in the bed. So that's cool. And going forward, there's a new technology called a fiber laser. And that's probably next.
Okay.
So it'll allow us to mark uncoated metal, which doesn't mean much to most people, but it's something where we struggle to do that now. So it would be nice to
yeah.
have.
I'm
way.
Still stuck at Mylar because I remember that's in Mylar balloons.
Yeah, well, so how, you know, how they're shiny and metallic looking?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Well, it's that, but it's with your image or your logo or
okay.
your graphic.
So you just have to bring it down for me, put it on a level that I can understand. So that's very cool. I think that people walk by and they see the trophies and they see the awards and they're like, yeah, okay, that's nice. You know, and they just don't think about the wine bottles and the wine glasses and the different gift ideas. I know it's not the same. I know you might be able to do some, I'm guessing. I remember back in the day, and I haven't been to a mall in God knows how long, there used to be a store called Things Remembered.
Still is.
Okay. Let's pretend for the sake of argument, they're not around here, they're not prevalent, but I remember they did a lot of the personalizing and stuff. Sort of a comparable thing.
Oh, we can do all that and more.
There you go. See? I remember...
for a lot less money.
I got a pocket watch, which still sits collecting dust in the box. So. That came in that I gave to my husband, who doesn't wear watches. So at the time, I was like, well, I'll get him a pocket watch because he doesn't wear watches. He doesn't put watches in his pocket either, apparently. But it'll be a keepsake, and we'll, you know, because it's engraved. But so you can do stuff like that too. Then yes.
Yes.
Now, would that be a bring it in item? Or
yeah, we don't sell jewelry.
Okay. But that's one of those things where, again, liability waiver thing, but if you brought it to us, we can
figure out a way to market. Yes,
that is awesome.
Now, we don't do insides of rings.
That's
but the fiber can do that. So,
okay.
We don't have that yet.
Okay.
That's probably 2018's acquisition.
Very cool. So something for us to keep an eye out on. We have a pretty active Facebook page.
Yeah.
Rather direct people to your website to if they want to look around before.
If you want to look around at product or learn about processes, that would be the website. If you want to see where we've been out in the community active, that would be Facebook.
Okay.
We support a lot of organizations and try to stay active in the community.
Anything local you want to give a shout out to? You don't have to.
Well, the Red Devils are going to be hosting Wine, Women, and Shoes soon. So the Red Devils are a nonprofit organization that supports families battling breast cancer.
Yep.
And they have one of their main fundraisers of the year is Wine, Women, and Shoes. And it's a ton of fun. Just what it sounds, wine, women, and shoes, and shopping and eating. And,
So you're doing the wine glasses for that, or you're doing anything that's promotional related to that?
Yeah, we're doing... Well, I'm on the board for them, so I'm helping them in whatever way I can.
Very cool.
Actually, I think we're doing shot glasses this year.
Nice.
Tito's Vodka is one of the sponsors, so we're going to do some shot glasses.
Very cool. Well, what haven't we covered that you want to leave people with so they can learn more about you or more about your business or the services you provide? What haven't I covered or given you a chance to talk about, because I tend to talk a lot?
You've given me ample opportunity.
Okay.
I would just say that if there's ever a time where you want to imprint a message or artwork or graphic on an item, we can help.
Okay, very good. And before we go, what do we have on here? These are samples. I know you didn't do these, but
no.
You can do
We
models.
Could, yes. But right here, this is a plaque. And it's kind of cool because it can also stand as well as sit, hang.
Okay.
And it's got a floating panel, and it's got a couple layers going on with printing. This is the direct UV printer.
Okay.
So it's got lots of color and something different from a standard walnut plaque that
has
been around for years.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
So that's something different.
Very nice.
And then here's an acrylic award. Now this is thin acrylic. We work up to 3/4 inch thick. This could be any shape at all. It doesn't have to be a teardrop.
Okay.
This was a teardrop for the Red Cross or a blood droplet. So we can cut this in any shape, print it in any colors, and mount it to a number of different bases to create a unique award.
Very cool. Well, as we mentioned earlier, you actually are mostly at the Towson location?
Timonium, yes.
Timonium, sorry.
That's okay.
But here, if you come to the Oaktown location where we are today, you will probably see Amber.
Amber and Stephanie.
Stephanie, and they can answer all your questions as well and take care of you. I'll have all of the contact information for them, website, Facebook page, you on Twitter or
Yes, Twitter
Instagram.
And Instagram.
Okay, very good. I'll make sure all of that information is on there. This has been another episode of Coffee and Cocktails with MC. I thank you for joining us, and we will see you next time.
Thank you.
Coffee and Cocktails with MC would like to thank videographer and producer Richard Schulmitz, video editor David Russell, resident mixologist Mimi Evans of Mix & Mimi Mixology, printing and marketing materials from Forbes Printing, and head of marketing Anna Amendelaer of AKA Design. This has been Coffee and Cocktails with MC. We'll see you again next time.